Now go to motion.
These children are learning to connect designs from their imagination to three-dimensional objects like toys, construction plans, or medical devices. Their understanding of 3D printing may still be vague, but that is the future of manufacturing. Engineer Gonzaga Ntege is dedicating time to teaching them so they can fill the expertise gap.
3D printing can also help you in creating realistic stuff when they're becoming real. Let's say you want to create a toy for a child. It can help you in development and also make money, earn money.
When you think of a drawing and start drawing it, you can also use the same thing and you put it on a machine or a robot to innovate it and put it into life.
Back at the Zopa workshop, Ntege has built a 3D printing factory from electronic waste. At this junkyard in downtown Kampala, motors and rods from old photocopiers and printers have become valuable. Instead of being discarded, each is added as an important component of a 3D printing machine.
What will they be able to do by the time they're in university? Just imagine, yeah? So what kind of problems will they be able to solve? So it's a two-pronged approach. We are using it to raise funds, but also we are using it to introduce the technology to the kids, because these are our future customers. These are the guys who are going to run the booming distributed manufacturing industry, in Africa in the next 10 to 15 years.
This 3D printing factory aims to solve the problem of low manufacturing for custom-made products that have not yet reached large volume production numbers, where one can use injection molding. The facility makes 3D printing process more affordable to the average Ugandan.
But the point is, can we be able to teach the children to think, sketch, design, produce, and solve our problems? Because if the master's students now are not able to make that connection, how do you expect them to start solving our problems with the current technology? So my goal, or our goal, is to enable us to reach as many children as possible, introduce them, because Tinkercad is free.
The project is already solving challenges with traditional plastic manufacturing methods, which require a very large capital outlay to start. One mold costs up to $6,000 and a machine $50,000. By empowering local resources, the process becomes 40% cheaper. Their goal is to use recycled PET material in the printing process, encourage the upcycling, and increase access to the additive technology. Razia Athman,